Hi guys, welcome to my exciting new tutorial about color theory. We also have a guest presenter today. His name's Murphy. He has nothing to do with color theory except that he just wanted to be a part of it. So everyone, say hello to Murphy. Guys, before we get started, I just wanted to apologize. There's been a few people who've been leaving comments saying that they wish I could do videos more regularly, and I wish I could do. But the reality is I do work full-time as an artist. I do have the coolest job in the world. I'm aware of that. But lately I've just been like chock-a-block with work. So I found it really hard to get tutorials out regularly, but I'm onto that at the moment. But to help with that, I've actually set up a new Redbubble store, so the link's up there somewhere. I'm off. And I've got lots of stuff like this cool, like this iPhone case, I don't know if you can see that, or posters and prints and stickers and stuff like that with my artwork on it. So if you love my tutorials and if you want me to make more, please jump on there and help support Fieldey TV and buy some stuff. If you don't have any money, naughty cat, feel free to like this clip, to share it, and to subscribe to the channel, because the gods of YouTube, man, they love that stuff. Thank you. I'm gonna start by taking you guys back to kindergarten and bringing back our old friend, the color wheel. To start with, you've got your three primary colors. You've got red, yellow, and blue. So they can't be mixed from anything else. You actually have to buy them. But when you mix those colors together, you get, obviously, green, purple, and orange, which are your secondary colors. And if you mix one secondary and one primary together, you get the tertiary colors, red-orange, yellow-green, blue-green, blue-purple, and red-purple. You will also notice that on one side, you have what are known as the warm colors, and on the other side, you have what are known as the cool colors. And what tends to happen with those is that warm colors in a painting will appear to come forward towards you, while cool colors will appear to move away from you. So let's try this out in practice. I've got red and I've got yellow. So if you mix the two together, you should get orange, right? Let's try the next one. We've got blue and we've got yellow. Let's mix those two together. And we should obviously get green. Yep. And let's try the last one. We've got some red and I got some blue. Mix those together and you get So what went wrong? One of the things that you may not know when you first start working with color is that primary colors, so your yellow, blue, and red, can have two different sort of, not exactly shades, but you can have a warm yellow and you can have a cool yellow. So cadmium yellow is an example of a warm yellow. And for the cool spectrum, I have Hansa yellow. So you can see side by side, this one feels cooler than that one, right? This one has an orange bias. This one has a violet bias. In the blues, we have here, this one has a green bias, which means it's warmer, then the ultramarine, which has a purple bias, and then in the yellows, a green bias, whereas this one here has an orange bias. So let's remix these colors up here using the correct warm-warm or cool-cool shades, and we'll see what happens. So for your orange, we're gonna mix together the warm cadmium yellow with the warm cadmium red, like this, which as you can see is more of a true orange than the one, the weird pasty looking thing at the top. So we're gonna go for a green. We're gonna go with Hansa yellow and I'm gonna mix it with cerulean thing. That is more akin, I put a little bit too much blue in that, but that's a better green. then the murky khaki one above. And then for the purple, last time we had a really, really disgusting brown. Let's see if we can't get something better with this weird red that I can't pronounce, plus ultramarine blue there. Yeah, that's heaps better. So if you're just starting out, and you want to buy yourself some paints, I'd recommend that you buy the two shades of each of the primaries. I also like to have the yellow ochre or yellow oxide is something I use quite a bit. I also like Prussian blue and raw umber, and in the next episode I'll be telling you what I do with those. And of course you'll need white. So good luck. If you have any questions, ask them below.